Hi guys, welcome you all to my channel. Here in this video, I am going to explain you the Tech Mahindra programming round, guys. That I mean the in 2020 Tech Mahindra Drive, they have asked a few coding questions that I will explain you clearly, guys. Here, let's see here. Yeah, here are some of the coding questions I will explain you clearly with clear explanation. Here I will explain you question and along with the code in C language here, guys. So that you can understand clearly. Yeah, here I have decided to make a presentation video here with you guys, because so that you can understand clearly by watching the code and by watching the question what I'm explaining, so that you can catch easily. So I have planned to make a video on presentation video, that I mean showing you the content and explaining you clearly. Yeah, here let's see about the first question, guys. Yeah, here they have asked one question. Write a program to return the difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers from an array of positive integers. Guys, when we are writing the code for a particular question, first of all, the main aim is to understand the question clearly. First of all, we need to read question once or twice or thrice, because so that you can understand what we need to write in code. So first of all, our aim is to understand the question clearly. So let's see the question here. Write a program to return the difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers from an array of positive integers. Here we need to find the differences between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers from an array of positive integers. Okay. That line is okay now. Let's see here. Note. You are expected to write code in the find odd even difference function only, which will receive the first parameter as the number of items in the array and second parameter as the array itself. Okay, here we need to write the code, entire code in this function, guys. Okay, let's see the function here. The function name is find odd even difference. So we need to write the entire code in that function and return the value. So let's see here. You are not required to take input from the console. Here we need not to take any input from the console, guys. Here the condition is that. So here we need to write the entire code in the find odd even difference function, and we need to return the result. That's the main aim here. So they have given a note here. So still now we have read only the question, guys. That I mean here the main aim of the question is to find the difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers. Okay, let's go into the code. Here the main important is coding, guys. Here I will explain you guys coding in C language here. Yeah, here let's see the example given below. Finding the difference between the sum of odd and even numbers from a list of 5 numbers. Here we need to find the difference between sum of odd numbers and sum of even numbers from the list of 5 numbers. Here the array contains the 5 values. So we need to find out the what are the odd numbers and what are the even numbers. And then we need to find the sum of odd numbers and sum of even numbers. Finally, we need to subtract the even numbers from the odd numbers and find the difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers. That's the main aim, guys. Don't worry if you haven't understand any statement, that I mean any something in question. You will be clear when I am explaining the code here. Yeah, let's see the input format and output format so that you will understand clearly entire question. Yeah, here input 1 is the 5, that I mean the number of items should be placed in array. Here I have given the array value as 5. Yeah. Input 2 is array values here. Here we have mentioned in input 1 as the 5 values, the size of an array. Here in input 2, we are going to give the values of that array. Yeah, here there are 5 values starting from index 0 to 4. Here 10, 11, 7, 12, 14. Okay, these are all the 5 values stored in an array, and output is minus 18. Yeah, guys, output is minus 18 for this input. For example, I will explain you guys here. Here the explanation is given below. Here first parameter 5 is the size of an array. Yeah, here 5 is the size of an array. That means only the 5 elements can be stored in an array starting from the index 0 to 4. Yeah, next is an array of integers. The calculation of difference between sum of odd and even numbers is as follows. Yeah, explanation for this output is given below here. 11 plus 7. That I mean 11 and 7 are the both odd numbers. Odd numbers means which are not divisible by 2. First of all, we need to check and find out which are odd numbers in an array, and we need to sum those numbers. Yeah, here 11 and 7 are these odd numbers. So we are adding those odd numbers, and then after here 10, 12, 14 are the even numbers. That I mean, even numbers is condition is the number which is divisible by 2. That we know already what is even number and odd number. Yeah, so that these are all the even numbers. So here I am adding these three even numbers, 10, 12, 14. So, and finally, I am subtracting the sum of even numbers from the sum of odd numbers. Here, sum of odd numbers is 18 and the sum of even numbers is 10 plus 12, 22 plus 14, 36. So, 18 minus 36, the result will be minus 18, negative value. Here, the result is negative value. Yeah, here the explanation is given for this input format and output format. Let's go into the coding. Here, still now we have done only the manually, guys. That I mean, here I have given 5 and I taken 5 values, 10, 11, 7, 12, 14. As we have already know these values and visible, but the computer needs to perform specific steps to perform this operation. That I means computer compiler needs to go through some instructions and execute those instructions, and finally needs to give the result as minus 18. So let's see those instructions. What are those instructions needs to be compiled by the computer to perform this operation and give those result as minus 18. Yeah, let's see here, guys. Here we are going to write the code in C language, guys. Yeah, see here, and also here given that condition is note, that here we need to write entire code in this function and return the result finally. Yeah, see here, guys, here is the code for that particular question, finding the difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers. Yeah, I will explain you clearly, guys. Don't miss it. Don't skip my video. You will understand clearly. I will explain you one by one, each instruction clearly. Yeah, see here first definition of an function. Here find odd even difference function is there, guys. Here it's accepting two parameters. Okay, here integer n comma integer array is the two parameters of integer type. Here arr is the array name. It's a function definition, guys. Whenever we call this function, these instructions will be executed and finally return the odd minus even value. Yeah, let's go through this function definition so that you will understand clearly, guys. Yeah, here first of all, let's wait a minute, guys. Yeah, I will explain you from here so that you will understand clearly. The program will start from here, main function, guys, from here, and whenever we call the find odd even difference function, that function will be executed. That I mean here function is there, function definition, that particular function definition will be executed. So that I will explain you from the main function so that you will understand clearly. Yeah, here is always the execution always starts from the main function. So let's see the explanation from the main function itself. Okay, na? Let's see here. Yeah, for that first question, coding question, we are going to discuss about the solution. Yeah, that I mean the coding in C language. Yeah, integer main function. Here this integer indicates that return type. Here this main function is going to return integeral value. So here integer is data type. Main function means here execution always starts from the main function. Okay, let's see here. Then after declaration of variables, here I have declared integer n variable of type integer data type, and here I am taking the input from the user by the keyboard using the scanf function, guys. Okay, scanf is used to read the input from the user. Here I am going to read the value of type integer. So format specifier for integer data type is percentage of d. So here I have mentioned the format specifier and its variable name. Here variable name is n. The data taken by the computer will be stored in this particular address. Ampersand n means here address of variable n. In that particular address, the data will be stored. Whenever we need, it will be accessed. Okay, so here we are storing in that n address variable name. Then after here, I have declared array of size n here, and we need to take that n value from the user through the keyboard. So here I have mentioned n as the size in the array index. Okay, then here I have taken the loop, guys. Loop is used to execute the same statement n number of times. That I mean iterative purpose, we are going to use the loops. Here we need to take the array values, so we need to execute the same step, that I mean the scanf step, n number of times. So to execute same step n number of times, it's very easy to place it in the loop and execute until the condition is false. Yeah, let's see here. Here the for loop contains three parts: initialization, condition, and modification. Here I have initialized the I value to the 0 and then I less than L. Still this condition is true, the for loop will be executed. When the condition is false, the control come out of the loop and execute the code after the for loop. Here I less than N is the condition and I plus plus will be the modification part. Here for every iteration, I value will be incremented by 1. Okay. Let's see here. Here we are going to read the values from array values from the user by using scanf function. So then after reading the values from the keyboard, here integer result is equal to find odd even difference of n comma array. Here I am calling the function find odd even difference function, and here I am passing n comma array as parameters. So parameters in the called function are called as the actual parameters. Here I am passing n and array as the parameters in called function. Whenever we call this function, that particular function definition will be executed. Here whenever we call that function, as we have seen before, that particular function definition will be executed. This function definition will be executed whenever the function call is reached by the control. Okay, let's see here guys. Yeah, print of percent of d comma result. Finally, we are going to print the result after returning that, I mean, integer result is equal to find odd even difference n comma array. Whenever we call this function, that particular function will be executed. So now here this function will be executed. Wait a minute. This function will be executed. That I mean the function definition. Yeah, see here guys. Here is the function definition. Whenever the function call executed, this function definition will be executed. That I mean the link is provided between the function call and function definition. Here integer n comma integer array, these are all the formal parameters. That I mean we have received these values from the calling function. This is the called function. Yeah, let's see here. Here the declaration part is integer odd equal to 0 and even equal to 0. Before we are initializing the values odd and even to 0 guys. Okay, let's see here. And then after for loop, here we have used the loop. That I mean to execute the same statements n number of times. Here we are using the loop. That I mean to traverse the array values. Here we need to take the loop. That I mean to traverse every element in each index. That I mean from the 0 to 4th index. We need to traverse the array. So we are performing the same steps n number of times. And each index here we are checking whether the even number or odd number, and if it's an even number we are adding to the even, and if it's an odd number we are adding that number to the odd. Okay, so to perform the same steps n number of times, here we are using loop, iterative purpose. Yeah, let's see here. Until this condition is false, this loop will be executed. So I equal to 0 will be the initialization part, and I less than n will be the conditional part, and then I plus plus will be the modificational part. Yeah, first of all initialization will be executed, then after I is equal to 0, and then it will be checked against the condition here, I less than n. Here 0 less than n, as we have already know that n is 5, 0 less than 5 condition is true. So this part will be executed. Then after, when the condition is true, then it will go for checking of if condition. Here if array of I is divisible by 2 is equal to 0, that I mean the value stored in the index 0, we are checking whether it's divisible by 2 or not. If the value is divisible by 2, then we are adding that particular value to the even variable. That I mean even equal to even plus array of I. Actually we have stored even value as, we have initialized the even value as 0. So even equal to even plus array of I means 0 plus array of I. The value in the first index will be stored in the even. 0 plus the value in the first zero index will be stored in even. Then after, if otherwise, if the value in the index 0 is not divisible by 0, not divisible by 2, that I mean, that means it's not an even number. So we are going to execute the else block. So here, if it's an odd number, we are adding it to the odd number. Odd equal to odd plus array of I. That means here we are adding that particular odd number to the odd variable. So actually we have initialized the odd variable to the 0. So odd equal to odd plus array of I. Odd equal to 0 plus array of I. The value in the 0th index will be added to the odd variable. So here in the same manner, we are going to increase the I value, I plus plus. Then I will be incremented by 1. That I mean, then I equal to I will be 1 and I less than n. Here we are going to check the I value against the n value. As we have already know that n value will be 5 here. So 1 less than 5, the condition is true. So if the condition in the for loop is true, then we are going to execute the block of statements in the for loop here. So here then again the value in stored in the index 1 will be checked if condition. If the condition is true, if block will be executed, and if the condition is false, else block will be executed. In the same manner, all the steps were in all the values in the array were traversed through for loop, and finally we are storing that even values in the even variable and odd values in the odd variable by checking this condition. Then finally we are going to return the value of odd minus even. Odd minus odd variable contains the sum of odd numbers in an array, and even variable contains the sum of even numbers. So when we after complete when the condition I reach to more than 4, that I mean 5 less than n, as we have already know n value is 5 less than 5 is condition false. When the condition in the for loop is false, then the control come out of the loop and execute the code below the for loop. Here when the I value is more than 4, that I mean 5, the control will come out of the loop and execute this return statement. So a return statement indicates that here we are returning the odd minus even value. That I mean odd contains the sum of odd numbers and even contains the sum of even numbers. Here we are going to return this result. That result is we are going to return this odd minus even. That result will be stored in the result variable name here, because here we are using assignment operator in the function call. So assignment operator is used to store the right side value in the left side. Here as we have already know that this this is the function call, and the function definition is returning odd minus even. That odd minus even value is stored in the result variable. Okay, now the task is completed. We have found the odd minus even difference. Now the result we are going to print using the printf statement. Okay, printf percentage of d comma result. Okay, this is the program for printing the difference between the odd numbers and even numbers in an array. Okay, this is the program, guys. This is the first question in the Tech Mahindra programming round, coding questions. I hope that we have got clear clarification on this question. See once again and clearly this question. This question is about to find the sum of odd numbers and even numbers, and finally we need to return the difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers. Here we are writing the code in function definition. We are calling this is the function definition, and we are calling it from the main function. Okay, that function is called in the main function here, and finally that function definition is going to return this difference between sum of odd and even numbers. And finally, we are going to print the and storing in result variable. And finally, we are going to print that result is using the printf statement. Okay, and the return 0 indicates the main function is going to return the 0 value here. This is about the sum difference between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers program explanation, guys. Hope that you have got clear clarity. Even if you have any doubts, comment me in the comment box. I will explain you clearly. Definitely, I will respond you as soon as it's possible. Okay, let's go into the next question, guys. Yeah, here is the question number 2 in the technical round, in the written exam of Tech Mahindra 2020. Yeah, see here, write a program to calculate and return the sum of distances between the adjacent number in an array of positive integers. Here our main task is to return the sum of distances between the adjacent number in an array of positive integers. In the same manner as we have seen in the before question, we have found the differences between the sum of odd numbers and even numbers. Here our the main task is, see here, before going to write the code for that particular question, the main aim is to understand the question clearly so that you can definitely try and get the good solution for that problem. Yeah, see here, sum of distances between the adjacent number in an array of positive integer. Here we need to find the sum of distances between the adjacent numbers. First of all, we need to take an array and we need to find the distances between adjacent numbers in an array. That I means, if I show you the input format and output format, so that you will understand clearly, guys. Yes, see here, input 1 will be the size of an array. Here the size of an array will be 5, starting from the index 0 to 4. Yeah, input 2 will be the array values. Here 10, 11, 7, 12, 14 will be the array values. Yeah, let's see here, I will see in the explanation part, so that definitely you can get clearly. The first parameter 5 is the size of the array. The next is an array of integers. The total distance is 12 as per the calculation below. Yeah, see here guys. Yeah, in the first two numbers, for the 10 value, the adjacent value will be 11. And for the 11 value, the adjacent value will be 7. For the 7, the adjacent number will be 12. And so on, 14. Yeah, here we need to find the distance between the adjacent numbers in the array. Here, we need to find 10 minus 11, 1. 11 minus 7, 4. 7 minus 12, 5. 12 minus 14, 2. That I mean, don't worry guys, where is negative mark? You may have got doubts. If 7 minus 12 will be minus 5. So don't worry guys, here we are keeping the mod operator. That I mean, even the negative number or positive number, the result will be the positive number. That means absolute value we are taking here. Absolute value is nothing but here, if it's a either negative or positive, here we are considering only the positive value. So that's why 7 minus 12 will be 5 here. Absolute value is 5. So finally, we need to return the total distance. That I mean, we need to add these all differences. 1 plus 4 plus 5 plus 2. And finally, we need to return the value 12 here. Okay. Let's see here guys, total distance we need to return. As we have seen in the before program, we need to write the entire code in the find total distance function. Okay. So, and we need to return the result in that particular function. Yeah, see here guys, I will explain you the program here. Yeah, here is the program for that coding question number 2. Wait a minute guys. Yeah, okay guys, let's see here the code for the sum of the total distances between the adjacent numbers in an array. Yeah, let's see here guys, hash include stdio.h and hash include stdlib.h are these adder files. These adder files contain some predefined functions. We are using those predefined functions in our program, so we are mentioning these adder files at the starting of our program. Without mentioning of these adder files, we cannot use those predefined functions in our program. It will give error. Sometimes it will not give error, but many of the cases may encounter error. That I mean, we may face errors without using these adder files. So definitely it's very mandatory to mention these adder files at the starting of our program to execute those predefined functions. Yeah, okay, then after here, function definition guys. Find total distance, function name is the find total distance. And here the parameters are integer n and integer array. Here we are formal parameters are n and array. The parameters in function definition are called as the formal parameters. Then after here declaration part guys. Integer difference sum equal to 0 will be the declaration part. Here I have declared a difference variable of type integer and also sum variable of type integer and initialized the value of sum to 0. Okay, let's see again. Yeah. Here I have taken the for loop guys. To execute the same statements n number of times, here we need to take the loop. Here I have taken the loop till this condition is false, this loop will be executed. Till I less than n minus 1, I plus plus, the loop will be executed. Okay, here first of all to find the difference. Sorry guys, let me explain you the main function part so that you will understand clearly. Then after I will explain the function definition. Whenever the function call is executed, then that particular function definition will be executed. Yeah, let's see here. It is a main function. Execution always starts from the main function. So that I am explaining you from the main function so that you will understand clearly. Yeah. Then integer n will be the declaration part. And scanf function is used to read the input from the user by the keyboard. Here I am taking the input from the user by the keyboard and storing that particular value in the ampersand n, that I mean address of variable n. Okay, then after declaring array of size n, n means here taking the input from the user, then after to take the to execute the same statements n number of times, here we are using the loops. For iterative purpose we are using the loops. Here we need to execute the scanf statements n number of times to read the values of array from the user by the keyboard. So here I have taken the for loop, guys. Okay, still this condition is false, this loop will be executed. If the condition is false, the control come out of the loop and execute the code below the for loop. Okay, let's see here. Then after reading the values of array, here it is, the result is equal to find total distance of n comma array. As we have seen in the before program, here we are calling the find total distance of function and passing the parameters n comma array. These are all the actual parameters. The parameters in the function calling is called as actual parameters. Here we are passing n comma array. N is the size of an array and array will be the value stored in an array. Here we are passing array. Array is the array name of here. Then after the returned value from the function definition will be stored in the result variable. That I mean, here we are using the assignment operator. Assignment operator is used to store the right side value in the left side, guys. Finally, we are going to print the result. That I mean the total distance between the adjacent numbers in an array. So here we are using printf statement to print the total result. Then finally return 0. This main function is going to return the value 0. This integer data type indicates the return type. Okay. Whenever we call this function, function definition will be executed. So let me explain you the function definition code so that you will understand clearly what's the concept in finding the total distance between adjacent numbers in an array. Okay. See here. These are all the formal parameters, the parameters in function definition. Yeah, and difference and sum data types of integer and initialize the sum variable to 0. Then after here I have used the loop to execute the same statements n number of times. That I mean here we need to traverse the entire array and add this total difference between the adjacent numbers, total distance between the adjacent numbers. Okay, let me see here. Till this condition is false, the program will be this for loop will be executed. That I mean I less than n minus 1. Till this condition is false, this loop will be executed. Okay, difference, for example, let me explain you the one iteration. For I value is equal to 0, 0 less than n minus 1. As we have already know that n value will be 5 here. I less than n minus 1, that I mean 0 less than 5 minus 1, 0 less than 4. That I mean the condition is true here, 0 less than 4, the condition is true. So if the condition is true, we are going to execute the for loop. Body of the for loop. Here difference is equal to absolute value of array of I minus array of I plus 1. ABS is used for the absolute value. Absolute value means either it's a negative or positive. Here we are taking the result as positive number. Array of I is minus array of I plus 1. The value stored in index 1 minus the value stored in index the value stored in index 0 minus the value stored in index 1. Because I plus 1 means 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 is nothing but array of 1. So here we are subtracting the value stored in index 1 minus value stored in the index 1. Index 0 minus index 1. Sorry. Okay. Then after here that value is stored in the difference. Difference, that value is stored in the difference variable. And finally here we are adding that value to the sum variable. Sum is equal to sum plus difference. That I mean before sum is initialized to 0, so sum is equal to sum plus difference. The difference will be stored in this sum variable. Then after we are going to increment the I value by 1, then I value will be 1, 1 less than n minus 1, 1 less than 4, the condition is true. So if the condition is true, we are going to execute the for loop body. So difference is equal to absolute value of array of I minus array of I plus 1. We know that array of I means the value stored in index 1. Array of I plus 1 means the value stored in the index 2. So we are subtracting the value stored in index 1 with the value stored in index 2. So that result will be stored in the difference. And finally we are adding the difference to the sum variable. Sum is equal to sum plus difference. Before the value stored in sum plus difference value. So in the same manner, the loop will be executed until this condition is false and traversed through entire values in the for loop and executed till the condition becomes false. And when the condition becomes false, it comes out of the loop and execute the return statement. Finally, this function definition is going to return the sum value. that sum value will be stored in this result, and finally we are going to that result using the printf statement. This is the program for finding the sum of total distance between the adjacent numbers in an array. Okay, here the main aim we need to remember is using the loop for iteration purpose and to execute the same statements a number of times. Here we are using the for loop, and here we are using storing the difference using the difference variable and sum using the sum variable. For finding the difference, here we are using the condition here. That means array of i minus array of i plus 1. Array of i is nothing but the index value. I is an index value. I plus 1 will be the next index value. If I is equal to 0, next index will be 1. And we are subtracting the value stored in index 0 with value stored in index 1. We are storing in difference. And difference will be added to sum. In the same manner, the loop will be executed. This is the main concept that we need to remember while we are finding the sum of total distance between the adjacent numbers in an array. This is the main concept, guys. I hope that you have got clear clarity. Even if you have any doubt, comment me. I will definitely respond you as soon as possible. And then after here, I am going to discuss you the third question in the coding round. In the technical round. Written test in Tech Mahindra Company Drive 2020. Wait a minute, guys. Yeah, guys. See here, question number 3 in the programming round of Tech Mahindra 2020. Yeah. Let's go through the question here. Write a program to find the maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers in an array of positive integers. Yeah, guys, all these questions are of the same type. Just we need to identify the concept. That means small concept is changed here. Here, the entire coding questions are only binding with the arrays. Here, we have the main concept is arrays here. Just changing the small task. Here, we need to find the small task. Here the task is nothing but difference between two adjacent numbers in an array of positive integers. Here, see here, before program we found that total distance between the adjacent numbers, sum of total distance between the adjacent numbers. Here our task is to find the maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers. See here carefully, listen. Simple task, guys, here in this program. Just we need to understand the what they have asked. The question we need to understand clearly. Then definitely we can start writing code for that question. Without understanding the question, we cannot move to write the code. Definitely it will be somewhat confused, and we can get the exact code for that question. So guys, while we are writing the code for particular question, gather more information from the question itself. Understand the question clearly so that you can start writing the code for that question. Okay, here our task is to find the maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers. Okay, here we need to find the maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers. Let's see here. I will show you the input and output format so that you will understand clearly. As we have seen in the before two programs, input 1 will be the size of an array, input 2 will be the value stored in an array, and here our output will be 4. Because here the difference between the adjacent numbers 10 and 11 will be 1, and 11 and 7 will be 4, and 7 and 12 will be 5, and 12, 14 will be 2. Okay, here we need to find the maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers. See here explanation. 10 minus 11 will be minus 1, 11 minus 7 will be 4, 7 minus 12 will be minus 5, 12 minus 14 will be minus 2. Here the maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers will be this one, guys. The adjacent numbers 11 and 7 having the maximum difference, that is nothing but 4 here. So here the output must be 4. For that we need to write the code. Okay, let's see here. I will explain you guys. Yeah. This is the function definition. Find max difference here accepting the parameters n and array. I will start explanation from the main function, because execution always starts from the main function. So when I explain you from the main function, so you will be getting clear idea how the control will move from main function to still the end of the program. Okay, see here, integer main. Execution always starts from the main function. Here this main function is going to return the integer type of value. Then after we need to write the code in the in between the braces, open brace and closed braces. Here declaration, here I am going to declare the value a variable n of type integer, and then after scanner function is used to read the input from the user by the keyboard. Here I am reading the input of type integer, so here I have mentioned format specifier percentage of d, and then after %10 in that part, in that address of variable n, the value will be stored so that it can be retrieved easily to while we are performing an operation. Okay, na? Let's see here. Then after declaration of an array, here I am going to declare an array of size n. This n value will be taken as input from the user by the keyboard using scanf function. Then after loop will be used to read the values from the user to execute the same statements n number of times. Here we are going to use the loop, for loop. So here I have taken the scanf function in the for loop to read the 5 values of an array starting from the index 0 to index 4. And finally guys, here integer result equal to final find max difference of n comma array. Here I am calling the function and passing the values n comma array. These are all the actual parameters. The parameters and function call are called actual parameters. Here I am passing n comma array as parameters from calling function. Whenever the calling function is calling the function, function definition will be executed. Okay, then the returned value from the function definition will be stored in this result variable, because here we are using assignment operator. Assignment operator is used to store the right side value in the left side. So the final result will be stored in this result variable. And finally, I am going to print that result variable result value using the printf statement. Printf percentage of d comma result. The value stored in result will be printed on the output screen. Return 0. This main function is going to return the value 0. So I will explain the function definition. Whenever this function call is calling the this function, that particular function definition will be executed. Let's see the function definition. Yeah, here is the function definition, guys. This function is going to accept the integer n comma integer array values as the parameters. The parameters in function definition are called as formal parameters. Okay, let's go into the code so that you will understand clearly here. Yeah. Integer difference comma max equal to 0. Here we are taking the variables difference and max. Max is initialized to 0 here. Yeah, here I have taken the loop. As I have been explaining from the starting of my programs, loop is used to execute the same statements n number of times. Here we are taking the loop for the iteration purpose. Here we need to traverse the entire array. That I mean to find the difference between the adjacent numbers. Okay, here max variable is used to store the maximum value. Maximum difference value. Okay, so to check from the 0 index to 4th index, here we are taking the loop. Still this condition becomes false, this loop will be executed. So that means, as we have already know, n value will be 5. When the 5 minus 1 4, when the I value will be 4, 4 less than 4, the condition will be false. When I value will be 4, the loop will be terminated. That means 4 less than 4, the condition will be false. Then that time the control come out of the loop and execute the code below the for loop. So still the I value is equal to 3, the loop will be executed. When the I value will be 4, the loop will be terminated. Okay, let's see here. Difference variable is used to store the difference between the adjacent numbers. Okay, here I am finding the difference between the adjacent numbers. To find the difference between the adjacent numbers, we need to perform the subtraction operation. So array of I minus array of I plus 1. So here in the first iteration I will be 0, 0 less than n minus 1, 0 less than 5 minus 1, 0 less than 4 will be true. So here we are going to perform the subtraction operation between the two adjacent numbers and array of 0 minus array of 1. So the value stored in the 0 index minus the value stored in first index are subtracted and stored in the difference variable. Okay. And then after, yeah, we are going to check the condition. If difference is greater than maximum, we are storing that value in the maximum. We are storing the difference in the maximum. Otherwise, we are going to skip this if statement. Okay. Then after, we are going to increment the I value, I plus plus. I will be incremented by 1. Then after here, we are going to check against the condition n minus 1. 1 less than n minus 1. N, as we have already know that n equal to 5. 1 less than 5 minus 1. 1 less than 4. Will be the condition. 1 less than 4 means here the condition is true. So if the condition is true, then we are going to execute the body of the for loop. Here difference is equal to array of I minus array of I plus 1. Array of I means the value stored in the index 1. I value will be 1 because I value will be 1. Array of 1 minus array of 1 plus 1, array of 2. So we are going to perform the subtraction operation between the index 1 and index 2 to get the difference between the adjacent numbers of index 1 and index 2. So that difference will be stored in this difference variable. And then after we are going to check the difference against the maximum value. So if it's greater than the maximum value, we are storing the difference value in the maximum. Okay. In the same manner, the loop will be executed until this condition becomes false. That means when the I value will be 4, the condition will be false, and then it's terminating the loop and returning the max value. The final result will be stored in max. That means maximum difference between the two adjacent numbers in an array will be stored in max variable. So here we are going to return this max value using the return statement. That returned value will be stored here in the result variable name, because here we have used assignment operator. Finally, we are going to print that result using the printf statement. Printf percent of d comma result. Okay, hope that you have got clear understanding to find the maximum difference between the adjacent array numbers. Guys, here the main task is to take an array to traverse the array elements and take an extra two variables, difference and maximum, to store the difference and maximum. Initially, first of all, we are initializing maximum value to 0, because before traversing the array, the maximum value will be 0. And here we are traversing against the array and finding the difference between the adjacent numbers and incrementing I values. And if the difference is greater than the maximum value, then we are storing that difference value in the maximum. In the same manner, the loop will be executed till the end of an array, and final value will be returned using the return statement. This is the main concept, guys. Hope that you have got clear clarity. Even if you haven't understand, don't skip my video. If you have any doubts, you can just post it in the comment box. I will respond to you, okay, with clear clarification. Even in mail also, you can communicate with me. Yeah, guys. Till now, we have completed 3 questions. And this, I think this is the last question in the coding questions, guys. Fourth one. Sorry. And one more question will be there here. Let's see about the fourth question, guys, first. Then after we can explain. Wait a minute.